Hello everyone and welcome back to Minecraft Feed the Beast Infinity Evolved Expert Mode with none other than myself, Blue Star. And yes, that's still a very great big tongue tie. I'm down here working on getting my essence generator made. That way I can, produce whatever I want, whenever I want, type things for the mobs. So let me flip the camera around here and look. So, I've done some more work. As you can see, there's the breeder, there's the grinder, right under here is the chronotyper. Take a quick look at this. This pipe right here, if we follow it up, as it goes over there, that little blue oral, if you follow it all the way up, it goes right through my Java barrel way up top. And I use the transfer pipe just to bring down, excuse me, my wheat. I'm just using cobblestone to block these other ports. That way, if eventually I want other types of food in here, I can for future expansion. Simply, I'll just be able to break out this one block right here, be able to access it, or use my jetpack and jump over the wall because all I'm gonna have in there is like things like cows or friendly mobs, stuff that won't hurt me. Got the power wire. It's gonna be kind of hard to see right now because I've blocked it in a little bit. But you get the power wire running all the way over there. It comes out of the bottom of my water mills over there. Chronotyper is very easy. It's all it uses is power. But the breeder, you have to give it food so it can feed. And then the grinder here, you got to take stuff away from it because it's going to give you outputs of two different things. So let's start blocking some of this in. Got some covers here. Hopefully, if I can set this just right, make it look good and stop stuff from going in the holes. There and there. This is gonna be a full block. See? Makes it look nice and neat inside. Cleans it up. Yeah, okay. Now the outside of the grinder, we'll look at the back side of it here. Any solid pieces it puts out, like leather, wool, meat, will get collected here in the chest, and the other outside foot will produce, the essence, and push them over here. I made just a little simple tank here right now. Left plenty of room if I need to expand it out. I can fill this entire room full of this open block tank that holds 16,000 millibuckets per block. They all link together in one great big uniform. But as you can see, it just pushes out here into the tank that we can fill up if need be. Got another liquid transfer node going out the bottom just to bring it over here to eventually going to be my auto spawner chamber. I can get out of here. Right here, I'll put the auto spawner when I get it built. That way I can produce whatever I want in this chamber and kill them. That means build another grinder, but that's down the road. So, we actually should have the basics of this ready to go. The thing now we're going to need to do is actually go and get livestock, aka a cow. So, golden lasso is what we're going to need to build. Okay, I did not realize you're an Eye of Ender. I thought you were just an Ender Pearl. Blaze powder, which is not too hard to come with an ender pearl. Luckily, I happen to have an ender pearl because while I was building all this, right after I put the grinder down, there's a enderman that spawned in there for me. Yeah, grinder took didn't take no time to eat him up. So if a enderman wants to be funny and jump in there, because the way they like to teleport around the whole world, well, he can. Just my grinder will take care of him too. It don't care. It'll eat him. So, I need blaze powder, right? Should be in here. We should get from a blaze rod. Haha, I remembered. Do 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 do. An Eye of Ender, woohoo! I don't want to throw that because I don't want to teleport. Thank you. What else did we need? We needed 4 string and 4 gold nuggets. Gold nuggets should be easy. Oh, look at there. 1, 2, 3, 4. And I just need string. String, string, string. Okay. It's one of the reasons why I've had this entire time. Whoa, hello. I didn't realize it's dark. Any mobs around? 1, 2, 3, 4. Yeah, as you can see, I got lots of goodies in there. So, golden lasso. Ta-da! Very simple. Take a little quick nap here. Now, the other way to do this, if you don't have a golden lasso, is you can take the food they like to eat. Like, for instance, a cow likes to eat wheat. You can take a handful of wheat, go running up to him, and get him to follow you. But that's a long way to get him to follow you. That's a horse. I don't want a horse. Cow. Ooh, zombie. Okay, deal with the baddies first. We have a cow. We have a cow. Golden lasso just works a lot better for doing this. They don't fight you. They don't argue with you. You just pick them up and they go where you tell them to. This is a long trip. Long trip. Run around the corner here. And there's a moo cow. We have a cow. So, I'm going to pause the video, guys, here. Obviously, for this to work, I need at least 2 cows. I'll probably get a couple of sheep and throw in there, too. So, I'll be back in just a bit. Welcome back, guys. As you can see, I've got a couple of cows and a couple of sheep in here. What the heck? You're not supposed to do that. Quit glitching out. Cheaters. Well, you know, here's my breeder. 2 cows, 2 sheep. As they get fed, they do their thing. Then the chronotyper here that you can see is I've got set to move babies. The dot side is the side that pulls from, and it outputs to the side without the dot. Thank you. And it puts them here. And as they grow up, the grinder will do what it does. So, there it is. It's working. We have our little machine up and running. Now, there is one thing I am going to do and I want to do. And that is simply I am going to get a slaughterhouse built because I may want pink slime down the road. You know, if I ever want to rebuild these. The next level up to replace the slime is actually to put in pink slime in its place instead of just slime. Instead of blue or green, just to put in pink. I don't know though. That may be something down the road I'll consider. I also know if I ever want to get the laser running, if that's the route I need to go, I also need pink slime. I don't think that's anything else I need. Let's double check. Let's see. Pink slime. Okay, pink slime is used in making the sneak upgrade. It is a slime block, duh. Slime channel, a frame puller, a magic pencil, magic crayons. Wow, there's a bunch of them. epic eraser. A sponge. Ah, it's using the runic altar to make the rune of summer. But that can use any of the slimes, it looks like. There's a bunch of things, options for it. So mainly it's going to be using the sneak upgrade, slime stuff, Tinker's Construct. Who else would use? Ah, slime crystal. Okay, slime crystal. Slime crystal, yeah, just pink block made. Okay. So there it is. The laser precharger, the laser. That's just two different ways to make a precharger. It's also used in the tools. What all is the slime block used in? Not a lot. Definitely, like I said, you can make it to make tools. So we'll consider that. Mainly if it's... The biggest decision is if I ever decide to make the laser. I don't think I will because I'm going to target the quarry. So, we'll look at it. But that's the basics of this. This will start going. These guys will eventually will grow up over time. We'll start to collect beastie bits here. And the essence will get shoved over into the tank. Which, what, I have, what, six of these right now? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Yeah, six of them. So 6 times 16,000. Y'all can do the math on that. Mainline right now, just gotta let this run. Let it do its thing. And by having it down low like that, hopefully it's low enough I won't hear it up in the main base. Won't have to listen to them too much. Here's my little garden we built last time. I did put a void fluid pipe on top of it just to get rid of the sludge. As you can see, we're doing pretty good on the wheat making. No major issues there. We already got 27 stacks of 64 before I could get all that stuff down there and built. So these 10, 10, 10 seeds are doing their job. Trying to think what else. Currently still only have the two windmills, water wells going. This one actually isn't full yet. So I don't think it's hurting our power supplies. Let's take a look. Yeah. Saying that this is where the power goes out of the bottom and goes up top. This is where it splits. Yeah. We're full power. We're only using pretty much one and a half water wells capacity. So we still have lots of expansion we can do before we have to worry about upgrading that quite yet. Not enough. Oops. I keep forgetting that. I hate that rock crusher. About one out of every three times I come up that ladder, I run into it and it rips half my health out, or close to half of it. So that's where we're at. Showed you the vat. We talked about the alloy smelter. So nothing really a lot new from last time, guys. Just make sure I catch y'all up to date and I haven't done nothing. So let's take a look at the quest book. We haven't seen that. This tech tree we should have done. Machinery, IC2 machines, upgrading power. I think that's where it talks about the water wheel. Yes, it does. More progression. Yeah, see from there on the NEI. And in-game goals is to build, just to get my applied energistics. I'm going to start building my ME system. So, magic tree. Kind of dabbed in it. You know, we built the Apocryph. Apocryph. Can't speak this morning. Batania. Apothecary. That way we can make our different flowers. Started working a little bit with Thumbcraft. We got a little bit of mana being produced here. We have it upstairs. I haven't dug into the witchery yet. I started some of the crossbreeding. They want specific seeds to know for witchcraft. Not sure how much of this I want to get into. Blood orbs. I know a good friend of mine by the name of Blovey, back in my regrowth days, he really got into this witchery stuff. I never fully understood it. Runic altar stuff I've done a little bit. Ooh, wow, look at that. The in-game goal is creative pull. Now for the hardest item to create in expert mode at the time of release. Good luck and have fun. Wow, look at all that stuff. A creative pull. Let's see if we can put that in the system and see what we get. Creative. Nope. Creative pull. That's portable tank. Don't think that's what we're after. But you can make the creative items here in expert mode. Here's a creative energy cell. You need the extreme crafting table. Yeah, look at all this. Wow. Wow. Yeah. Creative strong box. There's no recipe to make the creative strong box. The lock's easy. The creative strong box is not available. Creative portable tank is though. Need an ender tank. Sorry, an ender tank controller, a bunch of ender tanks, bedrockium drums, creative energy cells. Wow, that's a lot of resources. So this is made off the extreme crafting table. Let's look at it. Extreme crafting. I spell it right? I didn't see it pop up. Oop, I hear an Enderman. We have an Enderman below us. Let's go play with him. I see you. He's chasing. He almost got me. That teleport trick is sometimes scary. We'll run down here and take a look real quick, guys. I know I haven't got a lot done this video. We looked at some few things. We did mainly get this up and going. Yeah, you're noisy. None of you grew up yet? I think that's right. I think these guys can breed every 5 to 6 seconds, but it takes like 20 seconds for them to grow up. So. There's one thing I just thought about I'd want to do. I'll take that off for right now. And that's because it has nowhere to go, so I don't want it to go nowhere yet. We'll leave it like that. See, but there's the power connection up there. Like I said, I mainly use the wires because they travel a lot further distance and less pieces. So, there it is, guys. It is up. It isn't running. I was hoping that one of these guys get eaten. Oh, wait a minute. Maybe it's 5 minutes or six, 5 minutes and 20 minutes. Not seconds. What was I thinking? There's four of you in there. There's four cows. It's four baby cows and three sheep. What? Grow up, come on. I want one of you to grow up before we go. It's in there. You go the opposite corner away from me? Oh, sheep. Kiss, kiss, kiss. And they do their magic. And sheep goes. Come on, Chronotopper. There it goes. Come on. You're taking all day. Come on. When do you grow up? Mm-hmm. Nope. It just happened. It just happened. See? Yep, leather and cow meat. And this is now. That still says 2. That still says 3. This is now up to 459. So, just like that. That's how it's supposed to work, guys, and that's exactly what it does. Now, if you don't want to have to run around, you'll get, you know, bring a bunch of cattle and sheep down here, but you want more in here. If you simply reach in here and, well, there is a way to turn it off. I think I just got to put a redstone torch on it. Let me go find this out. Just before we go, come on. Do I have redstone on me? No. But a simple thing, simple just putting a redstone torch against the cone topper will actually shut it down temporarily. That way it won't transfer the kids, the babies across. And you just let them grow up. So we need stick. We need. Wow. You see redstone. Run back down here real quick. Most machines, if you just put a redstone torch up against it, turns it off. Some of them, like the harvester and some of these others down here, have controls internally to shut them down. So as you can see, it's working. You make me look like an idiot. Why didn't you stop? I don't want to break that one. No, you don't. Stay back. Well, these machines are the exception to the rule. Dang it. I just lost a cow. I'm gonna lose the sheep if I don't get him pushed back in. Okay. I have to go get a new cow, guys. I boo-booed. And I'm wrong. These machines cannot be turned off with a redstone torch. I thought for sure they could. Well, I learned something new. I have to go get a new cow. But simply, if I can turn it off. Not gonna be pretty, but I can turn it off. Just like that. And it'll go down as soon as it runs out of power. So I need to put the node back right there. I need to put this node click there. There, that one's reconnected. Then this one goes over here. That now the chronotyper actually will shut off because it'll run out of juice. Ooh, almost thought I broke it. Why am I making so many mistakes? I have no clue. See, as you can see, we all make mistakes. See, the chronotyper stopped, or it's going to stop. What it will do is it'll continue transferring babies until it uses all the energy up. And once the energy's gone, then it'll actually stop. It takes a little while, but if you need to shut it down to do minor work, best way to actually stop is to break it out of there. So, I'm gonna go get a new cow, and that'll be it for this episode, guys. I know there wasn't a lot in this one, but you know, we got it working, we got it going. As soon as I get a cow, is it nighttime? Yes, it is. So, as always, guys. Thanks for watching, and I'll catch you around next time. Bye-bye.